गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम डिस्कसिंग द क्वेश्चन पेपर पैटर्न. सो यू आर गोइंग टू राइट फॉर 50 मार्क्स. नाउ हाउ द क्वेश्चन पेपर पैटर्न विल बी देयर, आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट दैट. नाउ फर्स्ट मेन यू विल हैव द फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स, इट कैरीज 5 मार्क्स. सेकेंड मेन इज सॉल्व द फॉलोइंग, दिस इज ईच कैरीज 1 मार्क्स, सो 10 क्वेश्चन विल बी देयर, 10 मार्क्स. नाउ नेक्स्ट मेन इज 2 मार्क्स क्वेश्चन, 2 टेन्स आर 20 मार्क्स. नेक्स्ट मेन इज ड्रॉ द पाई चार्ट, सो यू विल दिस कैरीज 4 मार्क्स, सो कंपल्सरी पाई चार्ट क्वेश्चन. नेक्स्ट ट्रू और फॉल्स, दिस ऑल्सो कैरीज 4 मार्क्स. नेक्स्ट इज मैच द फॉलोइंग, इवन दिस कैरीज 4 मार्क्स. एंड नेक्स्ट मेन इज क्लासिफाई द ट्रायंगल्स एज अक्यूट, अब्ट्यूज, राइट, स्ट्रेट, कंप्लीट, रिफ्लेक्स एंगल्स. दीज आर द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ ट्रायंगल्स विच यू आर गोइंग टू क्लासिफाई इट एज अक्यूट एंगल्स, अब्ट्यूज, राइट, स्ट्रेट, रिफ्लेक्स एंड कंप्लीट एंगल्स. नाउ फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स. अ फ्यू क्वेश्चंस जनरली आई विल टॉक अबाउट, नॉट अबाउट क्वेश्चन पेपर, जनरली फ्यू थिंग्स आई विल डिस्कस टुडे. ओके, इट मे बी योर क्वेश्चन पेपर आर इट मे बी योर क्लास बुक सम्स आर इट मे बी टेक्स्ट बुक सम्स, बिकॉज I am not giving here any revision, but I am solving few problems. You can go through it. The symbol, which is a symbol used to denote the cube root. So you know what is the symbol we use to denote the cube root? Symbol used to denote the cube root is cube root of 3 or cube root of 8. This is a cube root symbol. So if you ask what is this, it stands for cube root. Or if somebody asks, write the cube root of 8 or cube root of 1. So what is the cube root of 1? 1 we can write how many times you want, multiples of 1. So it is 1 cube, 1 cube, 1 cube root gets cancelled. Cube root of 1 is again 1. For example, cube root of 8. So it is a perfect cube. You all know 8 we can divide it by 2. 2 4s are 8. 2 2s are 4. So we can write this one as cube root of 2 cube. Cube and cube root gets cancelled. It is equal to 2. Any doubt? Next. What is the value of 8 to the power of 0? It is always equal to 1. Any number to the power of 0? It is also equal to 1. X to the power of 0? It is always equal to 1. Any number base to the power of 0 is always equal to 1. In general, 8 to the power of 0 is equal to 1. Next, inverse. I am talking about multiplicative inverse. Multiplicative inverse of, for example, 3 power minus 2. So, how to write this multiplicative inverse? It is 3 power minus 2 by 1. So, we can write this one as 1 by 3 power plus 2. When I write this one in the denominator, it is plus 2. For example, multiplicative inverse of 3 power 4 will be equal to 1 by 3 to the power of minus 4. Are you getting my point? This is all about talking about the inverse, multiplicative inverse. If I ask you to write this positive number in terms of positive value, you can write this is equal to 1 by 3 power 4. 5 to the power of minus, see for example, if it is 1 by 5 to the power of minus 3, so what is the positive exponent? 5 to the power of plus 3. So you write this one into the numerator. It is 1 by, but this is 5 to the power of 3 by 1. Next, expansion. What is expansion? What is expansion of a minus b whole square? Expand it. Write the formula. Based on formula, a square minus 2ab plus b square. What is a plus b whole square? A square plus 2ab plus b square. Same way, a plus b into a minus b. So it is nothing but a square minus b square. You have all the formulas. Go through formulas once. Next, exponential form. Writing in exponential form. For example, m x to the power of 2 into m x to the power m to the power of 2 x is equal to, this is nothing is that its power is 1. So we can write n to the power of 3 into x to the power of 3. Yes, same way a into b to the power of 3 into b to a to the power of 2 into b. So here nothing is there means its power is 1. Here also 1. This is 2 plus 1 is 3 and this is 3 plus 1 is 4. Any doubt? Next, simplify and express with positive exponent. So you have to simplify it, the given exponential form, and you have to write it in the simple form with a positive exponent. One sum I will do for you. Similarly, you can take some sums and you can do it. -10/(-5) into 2^-3. For example, okay, this we can write it as 2^-10 division symbol write by 2^-5 into 2^-3. So we can write this one as the positive term. How? If we can write this one as using the law of exponents, a to the power of n is nothing but a to the power of m minus n. Same way, 2^-10/(-5) is equal to 2^-10 - (-5). So it is 2^-10 + 5. It is 2^(5 - 10) - (-5). Yes, so what I got here, -5 × (2^-3). Now use the law of exponent, first law, a^(m) × (a^n) = (a^m + n). Same way, 2^(5 - 5) + (-3), it is nothing but 2^(-5) + (-3). It is 2^-8. Or you can write this one, inverse of this is 2^+8. Similarly, you have to work out the sums based on simplification of the exponent and writing in terms of positive number. Next, I'll discuss about factorization. What is this factorization? What is meant by factorization? For example, (x^(2+xy) + (8x + 8y). Now group the terms. Now you will group like this, x² was one term, xy as one term, and 8x as one term, 8y as one term. Now from this, we can take x as common. What is left? x + y. Here this is multiples of 8. So what is left? x + y. So here now this is common, x + y. And this is x + 8. Now what, which are the factors of this? x + y × (x + 8). This is all about the factorization. Now I am talking about the prime factorization method. What is this prime factorization method? So for example, here one number will be given. So that is 64. For example, 64 is given. So what is prime factorization? Divide this by prime number. Which is the smallest prime even number? It is 2. Divide this number by 2. 2 3s are 6. 2 2s are 4. Again we can divide by 2. 2 1s are 2. 1 is left. 2 1 1 12. 2 6s are 12. Again 2 8s are 16. Again 2 4s are 8. Again 2 2s are 4. 2 2 2 × 2 × 2. So it is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 2^6. Any doubt? This is all about the prime factorization. Now writing the given number in the standard form, that you go through it. Then if you toss two coins or one coin, which are the possibilities? Tossing one coin. So one coin if you toss, either you get head or tail. Yes, these are the outcomes of the one coin. If you toss two coins together, two coins together. What are the possibilities? Head are head, both are head, and both are tail, her head and tail, and tail are head. These are the four possibilities. These are the four possibilities of when you toss a coin, two coins. When you toss two coins, we get these four possibilities. Any doubt? Next, factorize division. One example I'll do based on division. Divide 15x minus 50 divided by 5. So how you do this one? A binomial by a monomial. So how to write this one? 15x minus 50 by 5. This 5 denominator belongs to both the numerator. It is 15x by 5 minus 50 by 5. 5 ones are 5, 5 threes are 15. 5 ones are 5 tens are. So it is equal to 3x minus 10. Any doubt? This is all about division question. Next, what is a need? For example, you all know now how to plot the graph. So when you plot the graph, this what we call the slope, that is the vertical line, the horizontal line, and this is vertical line. Vertical line is called as y-axis, the horizontal line is called as x-axis, and both they meet at origin. X and y-axis meet at origin, that is the coordinates of the origin is 0, 0. What is the name of x-axis? We call it as abscissa. And what is the name of the y-axis? It is ordinate. Understood? On x-axis, what type of points are located? All the positive numbers are located. On y-axis, what type of ordinates are located? Coordinates are minus values. On y-axis, again, positive number. And y dash is negative number. So this is first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, and fourth quadrant. This is x is also positive and y is also positive. Both the values are positive here. Your x is positive, negative number, y is positive. And this is both are negative number. This one is a positive and a negative number. For example, plus 2 and minus 2, it is located in fourth quadrant. This is how to locate the points in the on the graph paper. Next, when you throw a die, what are the possibilities are there? When you throw one die, you may get one. How many faces it has? 6 faces. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are 6. These are the possibilities are there when you put one die. When you throw two die, so which are the possibilities are there? 1, 1. So this I think you don't have. When you throw a die, one die, we have this 6 possibilities. Which are prime numbers here? 2, 3 and 5 are prime numbers. So which are the prime numbers? 2, 3 and 5. Which are not prime numbers? 1, 4 and 6 are not prime numbers. Which are greater than 5? Only 1, 6. Greater than 5 is 6. Only one number. How many are lesser than 6? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 possibilities. So 5 possibilities are there. You may get less than 6. Any doubt? This is all about the probability. How to locate the points on the graph sheet also, I think you all know. Which are prisms among the following that you are going to identify? Prisms. Name of the prism. Which are prism, which are not prism, that you have to identify and write it. And here, Euler's formula. You have to calculate the Euler's formula. What is Euler's formula? F plus V is equal to E plus 2. What is F? Number of faces. What is V? Vertices. Number of vertices. What is E? E stands for edge. For example, here, this is a cube, right? How many faces it has? A cube has 6 equal faces. So, faces are here 6. No doubt about it. It has 6 faces. What is meant by vertices? These points where these line segments will meet. No, these are called points. So how many points are there? We have here 8 vertices. Edges. Edges means line segments. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 edges are there. Edges means line segment. How to verify this Euler's formula? F plus B should be equal to E plus 2. F is 6, V is 8. 6 plus 8 is 14. E is 12. 12 plus 2, again here we get 14. So F plus V is equal to E plus 2. Any doubt you have? So shall I move to next? So draw histogram. That also you have to practice, children. Histogram drawing, pie chart. You have problems based on histogram. So what is the difference between histogram and bar graph? You have bar graph problem, pie chart problems. What is the difference between histogram and bar graph? Even both also looks like a bar. Both also looks like rectangle shape, right? But in a histogram, there is no gaps between two intervals. But in a bar graph, we have gaps, right? Like this. So both also you go through histogram as well as bar graph. Pie chart, you take the compass correctly, sharp your pencil. First you draw the circle, then you mark the measurements. Then I'll discuss about true or false. So this carries 4 marks, children. True or false. So if it is false, you are going to correct it. What is the correct statement? Okay, then only it carries 1 mark each. So cube of any odd number. What is cube of odd number? What? Which are the odd numbers? 1, 3, 5, 7. All these are odd numbers. What is odd number? The number which will divide, which cannot divide by 2. Which are not divisible by 2. So 1 is not divisible, 3 is not divisible, 5 is not divisible, 7 is not divisible. These are even numbers, odd numbers, etc. 9, 11, 13, all these are. When you write the cube, for example, what is the cube of 3? 3 into 3 into 3. 3 threes are 9, 9 threes are 27. So when you take the cube of an odd number, again we are getting here odd number. Again we are getting here odd number. When you do the cube of 2, now again we are getting here what type of number you are getting? 2 2's are 4, 4 2's are 8. Now 1 cube is 1 into 1 into 1. It is 1. What is 5 cube? 5 is an odd number. So 5 into 5 into 5. 5 is a 25, 25 is a 125. So whether it is a even or odd, both also odd numbers. Any doubt? So when you take the cube of any odd number, we get one more odd number, not an even number. Any doubt you have? Which are perfect cubes? One cube is how much? 1 into 1 into 1. 1 ones are 1, 1 ones are 1. 2 cube. 2 into 2 into 2. 2 2's are 4. 4 2's are 8. Next 3 cube. 3 into 3 into 3. 3 3's are 4, 9. 9 3's are 27. So 4 cube. 4 into 4 into 4. 4 4's are 16. 16 4's are 64. Same way 5 cube. So 5 into 5 into 5. 5 5's are 25. 25 5's are 125. Now which are the perfect cubes? 1, 8, 27. 64, 125, etc. So these are all about the cubes. Next, I am talking about the match the following. Match the following you have here. The different types of shapes are given. So match the following is based on shapes. Match the following is based on shapes. For example, what is this? Which are 2D, which are 3D? What is meant by 2D? Two dimensional figures are called 2D. A rectangle is 2D or 3D? It is a 2D. Why? Because your length and breadth only we measure. So we call it as 2D, two dimensional figures, and it is a rectangle. Any doubt? Now one more example. Square. What is the difference between square and rectangle? Here all the sides are same. Even this is also 2D dimensional figure and the name of the solid is square. When it comes to what is this? All the six sides are same, six faces are same. It is a cube. Name of the solid is cube. Here, this is called length, this is height, and this is breadth. So, this is length, breadth, and height. It is three dimensional figures. Okay, what is the difference between two dimensional, three dimensional, and this is what? It is rectangular in shape, and this has six faces, and all the faces are rectangular in shape. This is 3D, and this is name of the solid is cuboid. This is what? Cuboid. Even this is also three dimensional figures, and it is a cuboid. Next, this is what? The border is made up of rectangle, and the base and top is made up of circles. So it comes under three dimensional figures. So it is a cylinder. Name of the solid is cylinder. These are different types of shapes. Based on this, I have asked for 4 marks. That is, I will give the diagram and what it is, a 2D or 3D, and name of the solids. And you have to match it properly and write direct answers. No matching. You have to write the direct answers. This is briefly I discussed about the question paper. Not everything. Briefly I gone through the question paper. Now what is your work? All the sums, all the questions, whatever I have done in the class. Please, you go through your textbook. All the best for your exam. Do well. All the sums, you practice it. Thank you, children.